Hello students of class 10, this is the second part of the solution of NCERT chapter and questions. The question number 13, what is the difference between displacement and double displacement reactions? Write equations for these reactions. In a displacement reaction, one element takes the place of another in a compound. Only one element takes the place of another. Only one element is displaced. Whereas in double displacement, one component, each of both the reactants, get exchanged to form the products. In displacement, only one element, and double displacement, the one element of one component of each of both the reactants get displaced. The example of first reaction displacement is Fe plus CuSO4. Arrow mark FeSO4 plus Cu. Fe in solid form, CuSO4 in aqueous, FeSO4 in aqueous, and Cu in solid form. And the example of double displacement is HCl in aqueous form, NaOH in aqueous form, arrow mark NaCl, aqueous form, and H2O, liquid form. Now the next question is, in the refining of silver, the recovery of silver from silver nitrate solution involved displacement by copper metal. Write down the reactions involved. The reaction is Cu plus 2AgNO3, arrow mark CuNO3 whole 2 plus 2Ag. Cu in solid form and 2AgNO3 in aqueous form, and CuNO3 whole 2 in aqueous form and 2Ag in silver form. The next question, what do you mean by precipitation reaction? The chemical reaction in which a white colored substance which is insoluble in water is formed, then it is known as precipitation reaction. And that insoluble substance is precipitate. Now, example reaction, AgNO3 in aqueous form plus NaCl in aqueous form, arrow mark AgCl in solid form, plus NaNO3 in aqueous form. The next question is, explain the following terms of gain of in terms of gain or loss of oxygen with two examples, that is oxidation and reduction. So oxidation and reduction, you go through the lecture on this topic, oxidation, reduction, and redox reactions. Next question. A shining brown colored element X on heating in air becomes black in color. Name the element X and the black colored compound formed. The element X is copper and the black colored compound formed is copper oxide. 2Cu plus O2, arrow mark 2CuO. The next question is, why do you apply paint on iron articles? Iron is a reactive metal. In the presence of humid air, that is moisture, it rusts to form a layer of Fe2O3 XH2O. So in order to prevent rusting, paint is applied, which forms a protective layer over iron and prevents direct contact of air and water. Next question. Oil and fat containing food items are flushed with nitrogen. Why? Oil and fat containing food items get rancid due to oxidation, slow oxidation. In case the container or bag is flushed with nitrogen, then oxidation or rancidity is checked. The next question is, explain the terms corrosion and rusting. Go through the lecture in details of rusting, corrosion and rancidity. Now in test questions, inside questions of NCERT, why should magnesium ribbon be cleaned before burning in air? Magnesium is a reactive metal. When it is exposed to atmosphere for longer time, the oxygen present in the atmosphere combines and NGO is found on the metal surface. This oxide layer does not burn in the flame, so magnesium ribbon has to be cleaned with sandpaper before burning in air. The next question, write the balanced equation for the following chemical reactions. Hydrogen plus chlorine, arrow, hydrogen chloride. The answer is H2 plus Cl2, arrow, 2SCl. Barium chloride plus aluminium chloride gives barium sulfate and aluminium chloride. 3BaCl2 plus Al2SO4 whole 3 gives 3BaSO4 plus 2AlCl3. Sodium plus water gives sodium hydroxide plus hydrogen. 2Na plus 2H2O gives 2NaOH plus H2. Next question. Write the balance equation with the state symbols for following reactions. Solutions of barium chloride and sodium sulfate in water react to give insoluble barium sulfate and the solutions of sodium chloride. BaCl2 aqueous plus Na2SO4 aqueous gives BaSO4 solid plus 2NaCl aqueous. Sodium hydroxide solution in water reacts with hydrochloric acid solution in water to produce sodium chloride in water. NaOH aqueous plus HCl aqueous gives NaCl aqueous plus H2O liquid. Next question is, a solution of the substance X is used for white washing. Name the substance X and write its formula. The substance X is calcium oxide, also called quicklime. Its formula is CaO. Write the reaction of the substance X with water. CaO S form plus H2O liquid gives CaOH aqueous. Why is the amount of gas collected in one of the test tubes in acidity? in activity 7, double of the amount collected in the other, name the gas. It is so because in water the hydrogen is 2 times more than oxygen by mass and volume. 2H2O aqueous electrolysis, undergo electrolysis. 2H2 gas form plus O2 gas form. When you mix solutions of lead, nitrate and potassium iodide, what is the color of the precipitate formed? Name the compound involved. The precipitate is yellow in color. The compound is lead iodide with chemical formula PbI2. Write the balanced chemical equation for the reaction. PbNO3 aqueous plus 2KaI, PbI2S plus 2KNO3 aqueous. What type of reaction? This is displacement reaction. Why does the color of copper sulfate change when an iron nail is dipped in it? An iron nail acquires a brown coating of copper as a result of displacement reaction. The solution becomes light green. FeS form plus CuSO4 aqueous gives FeSO4 aqueous plus CuS. Give an example of double displacement reaction. BaCl2 aqueous, CuSO4 aqueous gives BaSO4 solid plus CuCl2. Identify the substances that are oxidized and the substances that are reduced in the following reactions. 4Na S form plus O2 gas form gives 2Na. In this reaction, sodium is oxidized to sodium oxide. CuO plus H2, Cu plus H2O. In this reaction, hydrogen is oxidized to form water, while copper oxide is reduced to copper. This is the end of the text questions of NCERT lesson 1. I hope all of you will go through this. First you write down, go through this, revise and then be ready for the test. Thank you.